E48 error message. E48-32, no signal on my DStv. What could be the problem? What could be the cause for me not to have the signal and have that error message of E48 error message? How can I fix it? How can I repair it? How can we repair it at home ourselves? Stay tuned to this video till the end. Like I always say, let's share. Let's share, guys. Stay tuned. Welcome to our channel, the channel of technician, the channel of business people, the channel of a self-employed people, the channel of technician of electronic, the channel of technician of refrigeration, the channel of technician of appliance. Your home appliances, our business, your electronic appliances, your refrigeration appliances. Yes, that is our business. If you want to have more information regarding electronic refrigeration satellite, yes, you are in the right place. Guys, if you are new on this channel, what are you waiting for? Just subscribe. Subscribe for this channel because we got a better content just like this one. Subscribe and share. Give us thumbs up. There, I know we are together. We are together because we start small. We start small while we are thinking big. We are thinking big. If you are with us in this community, I say it again. Subscribe. Yes, like I said, today we're going to be talking about E48-32 error message in DStv. This error message, you always have it. So tell me, you cannot run away from that error message, because this error message, you can have it for two reasons. You can have a reason because of your software, which is not good on your decoder, and you can have it because you don't have a signal or your signal is poor. That is the two reasons who can give you the E48 error message. There's no another two reasons. Software and your signal is not present or is poor. Now, I'm going to explain to you the first one. The first one, which is going to be the signal which is not present or is poor, which you can sort it out yourself. And even the second reason, which is the software, you can also reboot your decoder to get the software back. I'm going to explain to you how to solve your problem by yourself on DStv E48 error message. Okay, if you firstly have a problem of E48 error message, follow those steps I'm going to let you know now. The first step, if you got E48 error message, I will advise you to go and unplug your decoder from the charger. Or you can unplug it from the plug, unplug the decoder, wait for like 1 minute and plug it back. While you on this process, what's gonna happen is when you plug your decoder and you plug it back, the decoder will reboot himself, and then it's going to initialize the software of the decoder, and you may solve your problem on that procedure. Now, if you unplug it and then you plug it back after rebooting, and then you still not have your picture, and you still have that E48 error message, I'm going to tell you to do the second procedure, which going to be to check at the back of your decoder. At the back of your decoder, there's a place where the LMB cable from outside go in. We call it LMB in on the decoder. So you go at the back of your decoder, make sure the F connector, this thing, is well connected to the cable. That is can be another problem. So if you got your F connector, which is not well connected to the LMB cable, this is the F connector. This F connector must be well connected to your LMB cable. When it's well connected to your LMB cable, I have made a video showing you how to connect your F connector to the LMB cable. You even put solid tape, like you see this one, I have put solid tape. So now, what you need to make sure the cable, LMB cable, is well connected to your LMB in. You screw it properly, and you make it tightly or at the back. It's tightly at the back. If you make that procedure, you make sure that it's tightly connected to the LMB in, you go back again and put your decoder on and see if you still have the E48 error message. That was the second step. So, because if your F connector is not well connected to your LMB cable, or maybe the F connector, the positive, the in, the copper in the middle, if it's touching this cap, it's touching the F connector, you may have E48 error message. That was the second step. So if you did the first one and this one and you still not have your picture back, I'm going to advise you now to take out your remote and go to the menu. And then on the menu now, you're going to check the signal strength. You check your signal strength by using the remote and go to the menu. When you go to the signal strength, you're going to notice that you got a blue bar. If you don't have a blue bar, that means the signal is not coming to your decoder. If you got a blue bar and this blue bar is not like more than 60%, that means you have a poor signal. And then if you have an absence of the signal or a poor signal, your problem is outside on the dish. And on that case, you need somebody who know how to set the dish to go outside and set your dish. That is the third way of checking the problem of your E48 error message. If you do that procedure, you still not have your signal present to your television, I'm gonna invite you to do the fourth one. The fourth one will be to use your DStv remote, go to the menu and run your DStv installation wizard. Run the DStv installation wizard. Why you run the DStv installation wizard? Because by the time you are running the DStv installation wizard, on the step 4/5, the step 4 of 5 step, you're gonna see LMB type. And then if you are using a normal universal LMB, single LMB, if you are using this type of LMB, you actually need to change the type of the LMB on the DStv installation wizard to universal, because this LMB provides a universal type of signal. So you're gonna change your on the 4/5 step of DStv installation wizard, you change it to universal. If you change it to universal and then you don't see a blue bar, that is a sign that you don't even have a signal. Especially if you are using one of these type of decoder, which actually can use universal signal, or this one, who can use also a universal signal. Now, if you change it to universal signal while you are using the single decoder and then it doesn't have a blue bar, that is a sign that you don't have a signal coming to that decoder. So a technician must help you to check the dish outside. Now, if you are using the smart LMB, if you are using the smart LMB like this, and then you're using the Explorer, the type of LMB should be unit cable set CR, because that time you are using the Explorer like this. It can be Explorer 1, it can be Explorer 2, it can be Explorer 3. There you need on the LMB type the unit cable set CR. Or if you are using this S model decoder, the S model decoder also use set CR LMB. And the facility of this decoder is that you can put your LMB to universal while you are using the universal LMB outside. It works with this decoder. You can also put it at unicable. That means you can connect it to smart LMB and put it and set it inside to unicable. It still works. That is a particular of this new small decoder. So I'm going to say that after doing your DStv installation wizard, you should have your signal fixed. If you don't have it fixed, that means you got a problem outside. And like I say, a technician and somebody who know what to do should help you go and set your dish outside. So that actually is the fourth step you could do to solve your problem of E48 error message. I'm going to explain again the difference between these two LMB. Look at these two LMB. This LMB is smart LMB. It got 3 points of unicable and 1 point of universal. This one is universal LMB. It got only 1 point. So do make a difference between the smart LMB and a universal LMB. The smart LMB will produce the unicable signal, and the one will produce the universal signal. Because Like if you are using the Explorer only work with unique cable ZCR LMB signal. So those three one, this one is a universal. Okay, now the another point, this was the way how to do your troubleshooting, how to find out the problem of your error message of E48. That's what you can do in your house by yourself. And there's another way you can also check your E48, because if till this level you didn't solve your problem, I'm going to advise you to go outside. Remember, this cable, this coaxial cable, is outside. It's laying on the sun, on the rain, on the cold. And then most of the time, this material will come out. This material will come out, it'll get damaged because of the sun. And the cable cut, or the cable is deteriorized. The cable is not in a good condition, can also cause the drop of the signal, and you may have a problem of E48. You may have a problem of joiner. We use joiner like this and F connector to join cable. If you have on your cable, the cable is coming from the dish to the decoder. If you have a joiner, you must check the joiner. The joiner can also cause the problem of E48 error message. Now, there's another thing that can cause the problem of E48 error message. You have to go outside and try to do a physic check on your dish. If you go outside, see the condition of the dish. The dish got a bracket, got LMB bracket. Maybe the LMB bracket is tuned. The LMB bracket can be tuned. The LMB bracket can be broken. The LMB bracket may not be holding the LMB outside. That can also cause the E48 error message. Another thing, there are some dish who gonna land outside for long, and this just get rusted. Maybe the arm is now cracked, or maybe the bracket is not longer holding the world. You remember, on the wall we got fissure plug. Fissure plug will go inside the wall, and we got a screw who hold the bracket like this to the wall. Maybe the fissure plug is not longer working. Maybe the bracket is shaking. The bracket can be shaking. It's loose. It's not more stronger on the wall. That one also can cause your E48 error message. Now, that is another step. You can see there's many things that can cause the E48 error message. I'm just name some, and then you can check on your case and see which one would be your problem. Go and check on your dish. At the dish, you got your LMB. The face of the LMB look like this. This thing could be also damaged. And then what happened when it's raining, the water get inside because it's damaged. This one is still okay. But I'm trying to tell you that you must check in your dish outside. If your LMB here is not broken, it's not broken. It's not broken like this one. Look, this one is broken. And then what is in the case you have this type of LMB broken, mean when it's raining, the water get inside here. When the water get inside here, it's going to make you lose the signal. But remember, the error message always say to you, this could be due to the bad weather or wrong connection. That message alone have tell you what could be the problem of your E48 error message. So I have named several of them. Please guys, I believe and then I hope this could help you solve your problem at home. And then if you cannot solve your problem, what I will ask you to take your decoder to your nearest multi-choice or DStv accredited to have it checked for free of cost. For free, you can have your decoder checked, and then you will stand to know exactly how to fix your problem. Guys, if you did like this video, or if this video have given you a new lesson about DStv, please guys, subscribe. As you know, in this channel, we learn together, we put knowledge together, and we grow together so that it can be beneficial for other people who didn't have this message. So that share to those who need it and to those who doesn't need, because one day they will still need it. Guys, happy to speak to you today, and then I hope you're gonna have a beautiful day. Thank you for watching. Till next